could get famous. Boy, you had me at goodbye. My love's not a long time drift. I'm a sucker for your swagger. Only Tuesday nights available. We'll party till mañana, and then I'm inviting you to go home with me, home with me. I'm inviting you to go home with me, home with me.
Last month, I was at Hot August Nights trailer show in Reno, Nevada. And while there, doing some filming, I ran into some of the Sisters on the Fly. Who are the Sisters on the Fly? Well, they're a pretty large organization of women who camp and fly fish. And they camp in their trailers. They've all got trailers. And their organization is nationwide and now going worldwide. They've got almost 13,000 sisters in this club now, and it's growing every day. Now, these ladies that I ran into at Hot August Nights talked to me for a while. They asked me, are you the guy with the videos? And I said, of course, yes, I am. And they invited me up to the Tahoe event that they were having a few weeks later. Well, I wasn't about to pass that up. To go up to beautiful Lake Tahoe with 90 women and camp out for a weekend? Yeah, you bet. We're going to do that. So come along with me and let's see how this goes. It ought to be a lot of fun. Larry here, Mobile Tech with CanAmTrailers.com. And we're here at beautiful Lake Tahoe, California. Actually, we're in the Nevada side because the state line goes right through the middle of the lake. So right now we're at Nevada Beach in Lake Tahoe. And I'm here with Sister Amy from Sisters on the Fly.
You are, hi Larry.
Yeah, how you doing?
I'm awesome. How could I not be good on a day like today, right?
Exactly. I want to ask you a few questions. How long have you been mixed up with Sisters on the Fly?
Mixed up. So
yeah.
I joined about a year ago. I joined the New England chapter. And so I went to a couple of events with them in Massachusetts, met some of the girls there, and thought it was just such a wonderful group. And now I'm on this cross-country adventure, and I don't really have a social group. I moved to Tennessee for 3 months where I didn't really know anyone. And so I thought to myself, how can I make friends, or how can I get back with my tribe or people that have the same interests? So I looked up the next Sisters on the Fly event, and I found it in Tahoe, and I was like, you know what, I'm going to go and hang out with them for a little bit.
So you've been involved with the Sisters for about a year now?
So this is my second year. Yeah, exactly.
And how many events have you been to?
This is my fourth event.
And you're really enjoying it, I
think. Oh my gosh, love it. These girls are the greatest. And even if you don't know them, they're just so friendly and open. So you don't need to know anyone or have any connections. You can just show up and you'll instantly make friends.
And you're instant family.
Exactly.
And from what I understand now, there's almost 13,000 members in this organization?
Yeah, everybody's getting really excited because, gosh, before the summer started, they were excited that they were on 12,000, and now we've surpassed that, and everyone's kind of freaking out, and it's neat because you wait for, oh, who's going to get number 13,000, and it's a big, exciting thing.
I'm wondering who sister number one is. Do you know the answer to that question?
So there are these two sisters, Maury and Becky, and I don't know who's one or who's two. I think Becky might be one and Maury's number two, and they started with a group of their girlfriends. And I don't want to give you the wrong state, but I think it was out of Montana. And they just started because they were like, wouldn't it be cool for a group of girls to go camping and fishing, things that are traditionally male sports.
And that's hence the name, Sisters on the Fly.
Sisters on the Fly comes from fly fishing.
But are you a fly fisherman also?
Am I a fly fisherman? No. I want nothing to do with fishing. I don't want to touch any fish. No, it's disgusting.
But you like the camping.
But I like camping. I like being outdoors, and I like being social and meeting new people. So this is definitely a fantastic group, and I'm so glad that I joined.
Well, I'm happy for you too. And I feel very privileged to be the only guy with 90 beautiful ladies. They've fed me well.
Oh my gosh,
there's plenty of fun to go around, and this is just basically the the most fun group of people that I've ever been with.
Aw, thanks, Larry.
It really is. Yeah. And I've been with a lot of fun people. I gotta tell you.
Well, that's great. That's great. Yeah. We're glad to have you with us.
All right. Well, thanks so much for talking to me.
My pleasure.
All right, Amy. We'll see you next time.
Definitely.
Go have fun on the beach.
Yeah. Woo! Thanks,
Thank
Larry.
You. Hi folks, this is Larry here, and I'm up at Lake Tahoe, and I'm up here with Sisters on the Fly. They have an event going on up here, and this is the first trailer that I've stopped by to take a look at, and this Shasta Deluxe belongs to Julie Brown, sitting right here next to me. How you doing, Julie?
I'm doing wonderful.
And how long have you been a sister?
Since about 2010. About 8 years.
All right. Uh-huh. You really like it, don't you?
Oh, I do love it. Yeah, I've got 3 trailers now.
3 trailers. She says she's been watching my videos forever.
I wouldn't have gotten by without your videos. It taught me how to do everything. I knew nothing and I still don't know a lot. But when I got my first trailer, I didn't know anything about trailers.
So
I watched your wood videos and how to do the windows and everything.
Well, I'm glad you did.
Yeah,
great. Well, are you having fun up here?
I'm having a great time. Lots of sisters on the fly, and this is one where we could bring our dogs.
Oh, yeah.
So we don't always get to bring them, just some of them.
Right. So. You doing anything else up here? Just relaxing?
Just relaxing, yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Well, just tell me a little bit about your trailer here.
It's a 1960 Shasta Deluxe, and I've had it 2 or 3 years, and I've just been plunking along myself doing the work because it was painted bright blue inside and out.
And you got rid of all that paint.
I scraped it off with a paint stripper. The ceiling was the worst.
That's the hardest part.
And it's still, you know, kind of held together by tape, duct tape and baling wire, but it's not as good as one of your trailers.
Well.
But it's, you know, I just kind of do a little bit on it here and there and
that's the way you
watch
do
another
it,
video and try to upgrade even my own work.
Yeah,
so
there you go.
Yeah.
Can I take a look inside?
You're welcome to, yeah.
Great. Love the seats.
I had the seats reupholstered, so that's about the only thing I really had.
It's hard to believe it was all painted in here, you know?
Oh God, it was just, and I mean coats and coats.
You did a beautiful job. You really did.
I'm still doing.
And it's the ash paneling, and this is what you do. You do it with amber
shellac. I had to take these out because I was putting stuff inside and made this
sliding. Oh, okay, yeah.
Once, but I built that myself
because
it was gone.
Oh, okay, and you did the scallops and everything.
Yeah.
And it looks original. That's beautiful. Great. Yeah, well, they're all camping, so they're all using their trailers right now.
Yeah, it's not like
a normal rally.
Yeah,
know,
it's not like a fancy one, because I just camp in this a lot.
Yeah, well, she's beautiful.
I've taken this to South Dakota, Montana 3 times.
Oh, wow.
And I just got back from Glacier.
All right.
So,
nice.
Yeah, I've taken this all over, so
all
it's kind of lived in.
That's what they're for, right?
Yeah.
All right, well, thank you so much for showing me your trailer.
Thank you.
Now we're here with Julie, and she's got a
1965 Shasta Compact.
Shasta Compact. All right. I haven't done a compact yet, but I understand your husband completely rebuilt it.
Well, my husband and myself.
Yeah.
We bought it sight unseen, and don't ever do that. It's a big mistake. Even though you fall in love, we took it down to the railings because it was just not roadworthy. You would touch it and it dry rot everywhere.
Yeah.
So we literally built a box, and then I had enough trailers to know that what I wanted inside. I'm a sister on the fly. And so we made it, and I'm pretty happy with it. I've done thousands of miles with her.
Great.
Her name's Little Jim.
Little Jim. Yeah. What number sister are you?
3788.
37, well, you've been around for a while then.
I'm a very young sister, but I am 3788, yes.
All right. Great. Well, can we go ahead and take a look
inside?
Please,
take a look.
All righty, let
me
do that. Yeah, these little Shasta compacts are great.
Yeah, it's all I need, just for me. It's a little too tall. You're a little too tall.
Yeah, but I can duck. I can duck.
So oh. I love vintage, so I sort of do a 1950s theme.
Right.
The red and green and everything. This is kind of a fun feature that we made. I like my rolling pin.
Oh yeah, that's great.
That's fun. And yeah. Then we did fixed shelves
mm-hmm.
for storage. And then when I travel, I take bungee cords. We put little hooks here, and I take bungee
cords.
Oh,
I see those. Yeah.
And I hook it so that we don't have problems with things.
Keep
falling.
Everything in there. Yeah.
Yeah. And food pantry there.
Nice big pantry.
And believe it or not, this is my little toilet.
Uh huh.
For the middle of the
okay,
night.
Okay, Home Depot.
And you know what? It's all you need.
Yeah.
And that's my cooler.
Uh-huh. Right there.
And there you go.
And what do you have, a cooktop here? Or?
Yeah, that's a propane. It's plunged for propane.
Okay.
So I can have my coffee in the morning. Could cook a meal.
Well, she's really nice looking. And then there's the air conditioner. Boy, you got to have that in Prescott, don't you?
Not in Prescott, but in Barstow.
In Barstow,
when
you do.
When you're traveling
yeah.
to California.
Is Prescott pretty high?
Yeah, it's a mile high city.
Oh, okay. So yeah. it's cooler there then.
Not
okay.
as high as...
I'm thinking of Phoenix probably.
Oh, yeah,
it's
yeah.
hot there, huh?
No, it's definitely
yeah.
in good shape.
All right. Well, she's beautiful. Thank you so much, Julie.
No worries.
All right.
Thank you.
All right.
Okay.
And what sister number are you?
I am 8888.
That's right, 888.
888.
Come on over here first.
Oh.
Stand right here.
Oh.
All right.
Oh, you're actually
going
to talk to me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. Okay.
I'm here with Roman, and she's sister number 8888. That's a lot of eights.
That's a lot of eights.
Yeah. And you're a nurse, I understand.
And I am a nurse, and 8888 is what we dial at the hospital for a code blue.
And that's a cardiac?
That's cardiac arrest.
Whoa.
So when I got that number, that's the perfect number for me because I'm a nurse and I'm in the business of saving lives. So.
I wish you'd have been around when I had my heart attack. I probably would have just said, I've died and gone to heaven. That's what it would have been.
That's sweet.
So we're here with her beautiful trailer. I photographed it a little bit ago, but I didn't get a chance to get Roman into the act, and she just walked back up here. So.
Yeah.
We're going to go inside and take a look.
I bet you know what kind of trailer this is because you're an expert.
No, I'm not an expert.
Come on, Larry.
No, let's see now. What kind of trailer is this? Hard to say, really.
This is a 1972 Roadrunner.
A Roadrunner.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
I actually own two trailers, and I have a Jewel because I know you like the
Jewel.
Oh,
yeah. I'm working on one right now.
Jewel.
That's my trailer.
Yeah.
Yours is a 57?
57 Jewel.
Mine's a 54.
Wow.
And it was the very first one off the line.
I remember that.
You've been watching my videos.
I watch your videos, so I remember you saying that.
Well, let's go on inside and take a look.
Okay.
All right. We're going to go inside and take a look at this Roadrunner. And oh, I like that magnetic type thing there.
Because it didn't have a screen door, and I don't think I could put a screen door on, so I put the magnet.
Probably no room for it from what I can see here, but yeah. But this is a great idea, this magnetic screen here.
Yeah,
look at this. Oh my. Did you do all this yourself?
I did it all myself. I did the backsplash, I did the floor, I painted everything pink, had it, you know, powder coated, got all the pink appliances. And in the bathroom.
I'm going to venture to say pink's your favorite color.
There's a cute chandelier in here. I'll turn it on.
Oh my. A trailer with a chandelier.
Very foo-foo.
Just beautiful. These ladies just impress the heck out of me, folks. They really do. I've got a lot of women in my class,
well,
and they're putting
really
out beautiful trailers too.
What I did this trailer was to have tea parties.
Yeah.
And I've already had my first tea party,
right,
and it was fun.
This
I did a mother-daughter
so
tea.
Cool.
Oh, great.
Look at a pink microwave. Oh, my goodness.
Is your daughter into pink too?
My daughter?
Is she into pink too?
Not really.
Not as much?
Not really.
Beautiful wood too.
So nice. Thank you.
It really is. Now, how did you manage to restore this wood?
I didn't do anything. I got it this way. And something I learned from you.
What did you learn from me?
Gimping.
Aha. Yep. Brand new gimp.
Larry said, don't ever remove the gimping. So.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah,
well, you
so
did learn
something. I did learn something from you. I'm going to turn this fat out.
Okay. Right. Go ahead.
Yeah. Normally, this is all full of foo-foo, you know, beautiful foo-foo stuff, but, you know, we're camping, so.
Yeah.
We have somewhere to put some stuff.
Well, it's just a beautiful trailer. And I know the lady that owned the other road runner is going to be jealous.
Oh.
Yeah.
And I put up the shelf over here.
Uh-huh.
Put some foo-foo stuff in
there.
And I got my chilled.
Now, do you take all that down when you travel?
I have to.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah, you got to take everything down, so.
All breakable.
Yep.
Well, she's just gorgeous. Do you have
a name
for your trailer?
Victoria.
Victoria.
Her name is Victoria.
Well, Roman, thank you so much for showing me your trailer.
Thanks for coming.
I almost hope that I have a heart attack while I'm here.
I'll take good care of you, promise.
I'm sure you will.
Okay.
All right.
Make sure you're taking your Plavix.
Well, I got off all that stuff about 12 years ago.
Nice.
The whole life changed everything.
Awesome.
Did the whole thing.
Good for you.
They gave me 5 years.
See, you know what it is? You're compliant. That's why.
That's what they.
High five.
Yep. I'm their poster child now. When I go in there, they bring all the young doctors and go, this is what happens when they listen to us.
Yeah. Okay, I'll move out of my seat,
couldn't. Just gorgeous. And I thank you so much for showing it to me. I'm the only man here. There's food and alcohol everywhere. Some of the most fun I've ever seen. I've died and gone to heaven.
We love it.
This is Debbie, and she's going to show you how she gets her awning up, but we just took the awning down, so she's not going to do that. But this little item is something I saw a long time ago, and this is the first person I've seen with one in real life.
Wow, thanks, Larry.
Yeah, and it's just a little tiny winch like this, a little, what do you call them?
Pulley.
And
a
you
big
hook,
eye.
Yeah, big eye. You hook
and
this up at one
little.
End.
Yeah.
Put this at the other end. Uh-huh. And you can put your own awning up. Show us where it goes.
Yep. Okay. And this, you get all these pieces at Home Depot.
Right.
So you just take it right like this. You put the eye right over here, in your C rail.
Yeah, right inside.
Right
there.
Inside, and then it kind of hooks in. Uh-huh. Then you undo the rope. This is the part where you put at the end of your awning.
Right.
Now, once you put it in the end, I feed my awning from this way. I put this rope in my hand, and then I just pull it towards me, and
right.
it just pulls
slides
right
in there. Slides Isn't that a great
right
idea?
In. So when you're by yourself, this is the only way to go.
That's great, Debbie. Thanks. Like I said, I saw this idea years ago, but I've never seen it in use. And I was just going to tell her about this, too. Aww. And then she pulled it out and goes, I do that. That's
well,
great.
I did take this from another sister, I have to be honest. And I can't for the life of me remember her name. But she also has a video on Sisters on the Fly. And she came up with this, and I wanted to thank her.
Well, great idea.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. I'm here with Elaine and her 1955 Silver Streak Jet. And what number sister are you, Elaine?
I'm 1, 2. No. 1, 2. I can't read it. 2, 3, 1, 2.
2, 3, 1, 2. 2312. All right.
2, 3, 1, 2. I just woke up.
Oh, that's okay. But she's got a beautiful trailer here, and of course everybody knows that the Silver Streaks were built well.
Very well.
One of the best built trailers, as far as you know, I know. Gypsy, there you go. All right, there's your number right there, 2312. Well, how about we go in and take a look?
Okay.
Okay. Oh boy, do you tell fortunes too, or?
I do.
Is that right?
I have a table and a crystal ball.
Oh wow, tarot cards and the whole thing? I'll be darned. Look at it in here. Oh, just amazing.
I like to decorate, so
I guess you do.
So this one's my little gypsy.
Yes, it is.
Cowgirl gypsy.
Well, it's just gorgeous. I love what you've done with it.
Isn't she cute?
Yeah, she
and
sure is.
Everything's screwed and glued, so I don't have to take it all down and put it all
great.
Back.
Yeah, that's great. So you didn't want to cook in it or anything anyway.
No, but I do have microwave.
Well, there you go. Hidden away.
That's all I have. Oh. And I have a toilet, but I don't have plumbing, so I put a plastic bag in, kitchen bag, and adult diapers that you get at the thrift store. On half price day, you can get like 2 dozen of them for $2, and that's what I use.
Oh, okay.
It's very simple.
Very ingenious, actually. Very ingenious. Yeah, I should get my fortune told while I'm here. Gee, I don't know if I want to know. I've been having to see the doctor lately.
Oh, no. So,
and he's not doing a very good job of telling my fortune either. It's just beautiful. So you're really comfy in here.
Yeah. And Gypsy is, she's featured in this magazine.
Oh.
And then all my trailers have been featured in magazines. Let's see, Gypsy.
So you've
where
done more
you?
Than one then.
Where are you, Gypsy?
You're in there somewhere.
I'm in here somewhere. There she is.
There you go.
Is she pretty?
Yes, she is.
Yeah.
Oh, and there you are, all dressed up too.
Oh, yeah.
That's just great. I love it.
Cute, huh?
Mm-hmm.
This is Bucket, my little Airstream.
Oh, okay. Is that a Bambi?
Yeah, no, it's a caravel.
Caravel.
It's very much like a Bambi, but they didn't make them very long,
all
so
right.
They're kind of rare.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess so. Well, thank you so much, Elaine. I
You're
really
welcome.
Appreciate you showing
You're
me
welcome.
Inside of your
thank
trailer.
You.
I'm here with Barbara, another sister on the fly. And what number are you?
I'm fly sister number 4277.
4277. And she's also got a Silver Streak Jet. This is a 1956. And I hear you did this all by yourself.
All the interior, I kept to the original floor as far as the bed and everything, but it had to be rebuilt, and I built my booth, made my table, made my curtains, my lampshades, everything. So
that's great.
Yeah, it's been fun.
Yeah, and you're up here enjoying a weekend with the sisters?
Absolutely, always enjoy the sisters.
And where are you from?
I'm just from Nevada City, so I don't have a very long drive.
Oh, that's great. Mm-hmm. I'm from Yerington, so I don't either.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. So we're lucky, aren't we?
Yeah,
so
we
close
are.
To Tahoe, yeah.
All right, well, we're going to go inside and take a look now.
Great, go ahead.
All right. I'll follow you. Or...
Oh, okay.
Yeah. As soon as you walk in the door, it's just beautiful. I love the upholstery.
Oh, thank you. I did the cushions myself.
Who did the table?
I did.
Oh, that is really nice. Mm-hmm. That is something. Wow.
I made my lampshades. They're actually homemade. Mm-hmm.
And this is, boy, my 54 Westerner had the same exact kind of lampshades. Not
right.
not the same pictures,
right.
but this
right.
style.
Yes.
Yeah, and I loved that. It just pops right onto the bulb there.
Right.
But this is a beautiful trailer.
One thing that I have done is I did a faux wood finish because I missed the birch so much in my other trailers. Because I loved them too, but I wanted something a little larger once I started camping.
Uh-huh.
So this is just perfect. So this is kind of my forever trailer.
Boy, very original too doing that. This is just... Yeah, that just looks great.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, and it's fully functional.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, it's roomy in here too.
Isn't it great?
Is this a Marvel refrigerator?
No, I did have a Marvel, but it was going to cost me about $1,200 to refurbish it, so I just opted to cheat and
oh, okay.
go with this little guy.
Oh, yeah, I didn't see the handle. Oh, it's a Magic Chef. Okay.
Yes, uh-huh.
Yeah.
So
just doesn't have the handle in front
no,
like the Marvel.
I have a little microwave.
Oh, matching color
I'm
too.
Spoiling myself, so.
Why not?
I like to camp, but I like to be comfortable.
Uh-huh. I really like this up here too.
Yes, this is actually some wallpaper that I found, and I did a treatment to make it look like old copper.
Oh, yeah, like hammered copper.
Right, so I'm not quite finished with it. There's things I still need to do. But I did do the floor,
mm-hmm.
and I went ahead and used two colors, so which is a little different.
All right, yeah, vintage composition. I got to be careful in
That's
here,
okay.
I'm like a bull in a china shop here. But she's just gorgeous.
Oh, thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, everything. I really do like what you did with the wood paneling, though. That's just.
Yeah,
really accents it nice.
Yeah,
gets
really,
rid of that metal look.
Yes, and I really
cold
like
metal.
In the evening when the little lights run, it looks like a little cabin, and that was what I was after. And I do have a bathroom, and it is set up for a regular toilet, but I chose not to, I don't want to fool with any of that
mm-hmm.
stuff. So
black
I just
tank
have
and
a
all
little
that.
Victorian chamber pot in there.
Oh, okay.
And I did take off the original door, but I still have it. It's very cute. But I put a little barn door sliding, so, and I made the door.
Mm-hmm.
And so everything you see has been done by me, and if I can do it, anybody can do it. So.
Well, you sure did a beautiful job.
Oh,
I got to hand it to you on it.
Oh,
I didn't
you.
Expect this at all. I've been in a few Silver Streaks, and usually people modernize them.
Right.
And you just kept it vintage.
Right.
And
I really tried for that.
Yeah, and you're an artist. You really are.
I don't know about that.
I'd say you are to
I'm
put something.
I'm a do-it-yourselfer, so that's what I am.
Well,
so.
You did a wonderful job.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that.
All right, Barbara. Thank you so much for showing me.
Thank you so much.
All right, I'm here with Debbie, another sister on the fly. And your sister number is Debbie?
6186.
6186. And we're standing in front of her 67 Kencraft. Did I get that right?
68. Sorry,
68.
Larry.
I keep wanting to say 67 for some reason, but
that's okay.
67, 68.
Thank you.
So, how long have you been a member of Sisters on the Fly?
Since 2015.
2015. And do you travel much with them, or?
Yeah, I love traveling with my sisters because we're in a group for safety.
Yeah.
And it's a wonderful group of girls, and we're all happy to get away from our families for a little bit and learn some new skills, and I just love it.
And how do you like it up here in Lake Tahoe?
Oh, I love it. I'm from Reno, so I feel like I'm at home.
She's my neighbor.
Yeah, right on. Yeah,
just 80 miles away. All right, well, she's going to show me the inside of her trailer, so
sure.
Come on, let's go take a look.
All right, welcome to Tickle Pink.
Tickle Pink, yeah, that's a great... yeah, another pink fetish going on here, folks. Okay, let's go take a look. Let's take a look. I'll follow you.
All right. Well, please come on in.
Gee, it's right there. 1968 Kencraft, and I couldn't get it right.
That's all right. Thank you.
All righty.
Yep, we got some pink in here right off the bat.
This is a 1950s. It's not original, but it was put in. I bought the trailer in May of this year, 2018. Mm-hmm. So this is a 1950. And then I have a corner kitchen and some cabinets here that I just absolutely love.
Oh, and you did beautiful work.
This is one of the features I really like right here. I have a little cutting board.
Yeah.
And I got a dinette. And I have a secret door right here that has a little place for a dish towel.
Oh yeah, cute.
Thank you.
You know, the Ken Craft is designed a lot like the Ken Skills.
You know, I can't wait to see a Ken Skill. I have heard that, so I'm very excited.
Lots of glass.
Yeah, all the way around.
I've seen a few with the corner kitchen, uh-huh. which is just great. That actually saves a lot of room.
Yeah, I really like it.
Really does, with the dinette right here. Yeah. 8 feet. That gives. Oh, look at the telephone. I wonder if any of you kids remember what those things are.
I don't know. Maybe not. Yeah.
And then back here we have the mm-hmm. sleeping area.
Yep. I have a. It's called a 3/4 bed.
Uh huh.
It's bigger than a twin, but smaller than a full.
Right.
I have a dresser over here. More than welcome. Look at that.
Who did all the work?
Look at
the TV.
From a sister.
Look at the TV. Did it come with the TV?
No, I bought this from a very good sister friend, Julie Beck.
Oh my.
Yeah, I always dreamed of having a TV in a trailer, and it came true in May of this year.
And does it work?
It works, but I need to get bigger rabbits.
Oh, okay.
Rabbit ears. But yeah. It does come
it
on,
does
and then
work.
It goes down to that little dot.
Oh, okay. That can be fixed. That can be fixed.
This clock is one of my pride and joys.
Yeah. Gee.
And I used to be an Avon lady.
Did you really? And you're not anymore?
There's a sample.
How about that? All right. My mom was into Shackley.
Aw.
And the bath in the back.
Yep. Have a bathroom.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Very nice.
Thank you. It has there a sliding door on it.
Oh yeah, right here. Yes, it does.
Yeah.
Alrighty, it does remind me a lot of the Ken Skills.
Oh, I can't you know? Wait to see one.
Gee, look at the pink really in here. Wait. Now, how did you get this pink? Did you paint it?
The previous owner painted it.
That's beautiful. I wonder if it was powder coated pink. Mm-hmm.
Yes, they did.
Because it's a beautiful job.
Thank you so much.
Really nice. Really nice. I'm
nice
impressed.
Full size closet.
I am impressed.
I'm really happy with this girl.
You ladies just impressed the heck out of me. You all do such great jobs on your trailers.
Thank you, Larry. That means a lot coming from you.
And you really know how to enjoy them, too.
Yeah.
And decorate them.
Well, thank
They're
you.
They're really good. You know, the guys, you know, there's a couple of beer cans and that's it.
Hey, you're good to go.
Yeah. Well, I'm very impressed.
Thank
I
you,
love
sir.
Your trailer.
Thank you so much.
All right. Well, thank you for showing it to me.
You're welcome. Thank
all right,
you,
Debbie.
Larry.
We had to take a look at the back end here. You know I like trunks. This trailer has one.
Well, thanks, Larry.
And why don't you open that up for
oh,
me?
Oh, sure. So I was also attracted to this trailer because of all of the space in the back.
Uh-huh.
So you just go like this and got all this.
Oh,
I
yeah,
put my chairs
room,
and poles.
Spare tires hidden.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You got a table right here, a ready-made table. That's
yeah.
just great.
I'm going to put a curtain right here and go ahead and set up a bar.
Yeah. And does this light work?
Yep, it lights up.
Got a light there and everything.
Definitely
oh,
lights up.
Bar, whatever, food,
mm-hmm.
whatever you want to do.
Anything you need.
Right there. All right. Well, thanks.
Thank you, Larry.
All right.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. My pleasure. Oh, yeah, they got their dogs with them today because this is a dog-friendly place. And I'm going to duck so I don't hit my head here. Let's take a look. I think this is my first time in one of these new
really?
Vintage-looking trailers. So I've seen them in films, but I haven't been inside one yet. So nice big bed. Yeah, I like the dinette. I like the seats. That's great. It does have that vintage look. Air conditioner is kind of noisy. But it's nice and cool in here. And I see you got a vintage radio. Probably a newer one that looks vintage. And a nice big bathroom with a shower. And you got the fan in the ceiling. What does that say? A mule is the best makeup a girl can wear. Oh, I wonder if she goes to mule days. Bishop, California. Yeah, this is really nice. This is my first time in one of these, folks. Gotta be a first for everything, eh? TV up here, refrigerator. It's a Dometic. Yeah, lots of room. It's roomy.
Yeah.
And you can cook up a storm in here. You've got it decorated really nice. It's really fun in here.
Did you see my pink phone? Every girl needs a pink phone.
You got a pink phone. Where is it? Oh, another dial phone. Oh, it's buttons. Okay.
Yeah. Not exactly.
Yeah. Wow. All righty. She's gorgeous, Lynn.
Thank
gorgeous.
You,
love it. Yeah, you're going to have a lot of fun with this.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, thank you so much for showing it to me. I had to come around and look at the back here, and look at all these stickers. Tow Girl's sister, 5378, and she calls it Sweet Pea. Just beautiful. Lots of fun here. And, Lynn, I noticed inside on the wall there, it said something about a mule is the best makeup a girl can wear. Are you into mules?
Oh, no, not mule. It's a smile. It's
does that say smile? I thought it said mule. I'm sorry.
No mules for us.
Okay, well, smile is the best.
A smile is the best makeup a girl can wear.
Okay, well, I'm glad I asked you about that. Because I was wondering if maybe you went to mule days down in Bishop or
anything. Oh, no, I haven't been, but I've heard it's really fun.
It is a lot of fun.
Yeah.
All right, well, thanks for showing me your trailer.
Thanks, Larry.